Hello friends, how are you? I'm fine. Today I'm going to create a database RDS, and I will show you how you can connect to that RDS from your local machine. So let's get started. I'm in the dashboard of my RDS, and let's create a new database here. Create database. And I'm going to create a MySQL database because I'm going to show you MySQL workbench. Okay. So here MySQL, and then MySQL Community Edition 8. That's the one that I'm going to use. For this purpose, I will use the free tier, but I suggest you to use the production one if you are planning to use it for a production level. Okay. So I choose free tier, then I give the database name. That is sites and shops. Let's put some username, sites and shops user, generate some passwords. Okay. Then DB instance class T2 micro, because I want to stay within the free tier. If you wanted to use for production level, try then use a better class like C or R, that series. Storage. For me, 20 gigabytes fine. And I also check this enable storage auto scaling. What this will do is it will automatically scale up your storage if it is crossing 20. That means you don't need to manually check every time to see whether your storage is crossing 20, or you need to manually add those. That issue is gone. That those days are gone. You don't need to check those. You can enable storage auto scaling, and that will automatically scale up your storage up to 1000 gigabytes, which is specified here. Then connectivity, we are using the default VPC. That's fine. Public access, yes, because I'm going to connect from my local machine. That is Workbench. If you are planning to not to use Workbench, then you can use public access node. That means no one from outside the AWS VPC will be able to connect to your instance. If you say yes, then the IP addresses, which is whitelisted, they can access to the RDS. I will show you how. Then VPC security groups. I think you should use a good security group here, not the default one, but you should create the one from previously, like I just created previously this one. So you can create the security group before creating those RDS. And after you choose the security group, I will show you how you can whitelist your IP to access the RDS database. So availability zone, no preference, that's fine. Additional configuration, database port 3306, that's what we always prefer. And initial database, probably you want to create an initial database at start. Let's say create a database WordPress, start. Then enable automated backups. This is important. Always tick this checkbox, because this will automatically create backups for the last 7 days. If you need more, you can just click the dropdown and choose it from here up to 35 days. That's the maximum number of days that they allow. Okay, so I go back to 7 days. That's fine. Then enable enhanced monitoring. This depends on your requirement. If you wanted to enable this, then there will be enhanced monitoring available. If you don't want that, then I guess you don't need to check. And otherwise, you can keep as it is. The last checkbox I would do is enable deletion protection. So if you check this on, then you will not delete your instance accidentally, and you will keep your instance intact. That's the purpose. So enable deletion protection. So let's create the database. And it will create the database, and it will take around 5 minutes. for the first time, it will take around 5 minutes time, and you need to wait for that. So let me pause the video and come back to you when it's done. So I'm back. It took around 5 minutes to create the instance. I was taking some coffee, and you can also take some coffee meanwhile. So what we have a host name, that is endpoint. That's the one that we need to copy and use it for future purpose. Then we need to go to configurations. There should be a username, that is the username. Password, that we have used a strong password. Always use a strong password. Never use easy passwords, 123 or test, ABC, whatever. DB name, that is our database name. So we got all 4 things. Now let's try to connect. But before that, you need to add your IP to this whitelist. So let's go to the security group that we have chosen. This is the security group. And here, inbound rules, let's go to the details and click on, these are the inbound rules, and click edit inbound rules. I delete all the previous ones, and just I'm going to add a new one. Click MySQL. Then my IP. If it's not your IP, then you can just paste the IP. That's up to you, but it's my IP. Then I give a name. So say through. That's the one. So now we have whitelisted our IP addresses. We go to MySQL Workbench and create a new connection, which is sites and shops. RDS. We give the host name. This is the host name. We give the username. This is the username. Sorry. Okay. So this is the username. Copy, paste the username. Default schema. Let's go to WordPress. That is the schema is database, basically. So let's try to test the connection. It will ask for your password, and let's give the password now and click this icon to save the password in a vault, so you don't need to give it multiple times. Okay, so connection was I think successfully done. So I click OK and search here for sites and shops RDS. And this is now connected. We see our database WordPress that is pre-selected, and we see there is no database here. This is the connection. So this is how we connect to RDS, and let's create a new database here. Let's say Project X, that's the database name. I create the database. And let's try to refresh the page. The new database is created. We can create a new user as well. Let's go to users. And we create a new random password for the user. To add a new user, click on add account. Give the user the name, project user, give the password here, use the password, schema privileges, add entry, the database that you want to assign to that user. Select all, apply. That's it. So we created a database, we created a user. Now we can use this user and database to use in our application. It can be a WordPress, it can be a Magento, it can be Joomla, it can be a custom PHP scripts, anything. So what we learned from this tutorial, how to create a new RDS, how to whitelist your IP address, how to connect using MySQL Workbench, how to create a database in MySQL Workbench, and how to create a MySQL user. So that being said, that's it for today. I hope you like this video. If you do, please subscribe to my channel and share with your friends or colleagues who was looking for AWS tips and tricks, and then that will encourage me to create new videos. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.